Welcome to the Baloani project. Apologies first of all for the assay being a little bit late. I'm quite chilled about it. I guess a year and a half ago I would have been tearing my hair out going, it's got to be on time. But the fact is, it's been the summer holidays, and we took a couple of weeks off of work, took the kids all over the place, and of course we've got the new baby as well. And despite having the new baby and lack of sleep, I think this is one of our best summer holidays ever, because even though we didn't leave the United Kingdom, we didn't really want to take the baby on a plane, we just had really, really good fun. The kids, maybe it's because they've got a little bit older, were just very relaxed, and we just had a really, 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 really good time this year. And it was nice. I'm in a really good place, and I think a lot of it is definitely me having changed. Like, I've calmed down and not worried about being on time with the blog. I think I'm a little bit calmer with the kids. So I have definitely, without doubt, changed. And a lot of this is because I'm trying to actually not just talk all of these principles, all of this positive thinking, but I'm actually living it now. Let me just run through the essays. I'll talk for 10, 15, 20 minutes before you know it. And then you'd be saying, well, he hasn't even talked about what he did this month. So the first one was Say What You Mean. And I remember reading this 6 years ago, the first time I picked up Jack Canfield's book, The Success Principles. I remember reading it then, and it stuck with me. And I think a lot of that was because I'd been to theatre school as a kid, and they said, say what you mean what you say. And it's all about, it really is about, well, actually, if you listen to other people talking, you'll know exactly what this is all about. For example, you can say to somebody, how are you? And they go, all right. And you say, what's wrong? There's nothing. Well, you're just all right. And that people really get into a habit of saying things, so they don't actually even mean what they're saying. So when somebody asks you how you are, don't just automatically react to, I'm all right. Oh, okay. Just think about it. Are you happy? Are you having a brilliant day? Are you ecstatic? Or, you know, are you feeling a little bit lonely? So mean what you say. Say what you mean. And don't. Well, here's another good example. You could ask somebody about something, and they give you an answer that makes you start worrying, thinking, well, what do they mean? So actually think about it. Ask them more questions. Find out what they mean and get to the root of it. This is a really, really good one. And it also means don't tell them little white lies. And that's something I did on this holiday with the kids. So if they were like, can we do this again, Dad? Instead of just saying, yeah, and not doing it, I actually said yes or said no. Knowing, thinking about whether we could or could not do it. But we'll get to that. That's another tool, another tip toward the end of this particular series of essays. Also, when we talked about say what you mean, I mean what you say, talking about every word counting, because what you say could become, you know, what's going on in your life. I expected this to go down the NLP route, neuro-linguistic programming, but it didn't. But I have put a clip on there on the blog of Tony Robbins in action, using his language to find out what people really feel. And you'll see that this couple, just by talking to Tony Robbins for a few minutes in front of, I don't know, thousands of people, certainly hundreds, he changes the way they feel about one another. It's amazing. So just think about this. Don't just rush over this one and think, oh, that's easy, just mean what you say. No. Really, really think about this one and give it a go. The next one was Don't Doubt, But Find Out. And this is, you know, if there's something worrying you, maybe you think, oh, I'm going to run out of money this month. Maybe we're going to go into the overdraft. Don't hide from it. Don't just think, oh, we might. If that's the case, work it out, know the truth, know the facts, know what's going on, and then come up with a plan. Maybe borrow £100 from a friend or mum and dad, or somebody around you might be able to help, or don't buy something until the following month. So don't just get into a place of fear and anxiety and nervousness. A really good example of that is, you know, gossip. People say things, really, is that right? And you get maybe all the company's struggling, the company's going to go bust, things like that, and you start becoming nervous about your job. And these are just unfounded rumours, things that people might have said, stupidity. So don't doubt, find out, get to the core facts. Then we move on to uncommon appreciation. And this is, again, another one that I've really embraced this month, and having spent, you know, 2 weeks off from work and really getting more time with the kids than ever. I thank them for everything. If, for example, someone said, Dad, can I jump on the computer? I say, yeah, thanks for asking, son. I tried to thank them for everything. If they helped with the baby, feeding the baby, all sorts of little jobs, putting the washing in the machine, all of these things, really, really thankful, and showed them my appreciation. And I think it's fair to say that you thank people for doing these things, Kids, as my example, if I thank them for putting the washing in the machine, then they might think, oh, I'll do that again because Dad, that, he really likes that. That's helpful and he appreciated that. And another great one, and I use this example, is work. You know, that Jack and Phil lists 10 ways to make people feel that they're doing a great job and feel, you know, appreciated at work. And the list of the employees or the supervisors compared to the list by the actual people working, the employees, is completely different. Completely different. Check that out. It's impressive. And I really do believe, having been a manager on the cruise ships, I had as many as 150 staff. If you are thankful, if you thank them, you appreciate them, you congratulate them when they do a great job. Most of these people are going to work harder, not for more money, not for job security, not for the bonus scheme, but just because they're enjoying what they do and they really appreciate it. Appreciation is an amazing tool, so really, really do use that one. I've got loads of examples for you there. And then the final one is be true to your word. This is not just about, you know, keeping your word, but it's about thinking about your answers. And I used an example earlier, and this is in alignment with all of that. The kids, we went horse riding, and they loved it, and said, Dad, can we go again? And if I just said, oh yeah, we can do that again, the chances are that we wouldn't have done it, because we had such a busy schedule this summer. But I thought about it, and I thought, well, if I say yes, I've got to do it. So I said yes, because they really, really enjoyed it. And I had to reshuffle everything around. And I think usually, if I hadn't paid attention to this detail, because it was one of the assays, then maybe I would have just said yes, and we didn't go, we just stuck to the plan anyway. So don't break agreements that you make, because the whole point is, Jack's suggesting that if you start to break things, if you don't stick to your word, you say, oh yeah, I'll do that, honey, and here you go, here's a job, but can you wash my car for me tomorrow? And you say, yeah, I'll do it, or, you know, here you go, in my case, fitted wardrobes, I've been talking about putting these up now for months, and the last few days I've been saying, yeah, I will do it this week, I'll do it this week, I'll do it this week, and of course it's easy for another week to go by, but I actually did do it this week. So stick to your agreements, because when you don't, when you let them slip, what you can find is that you start doubting yourself. You don't necessarily believe yourself. You say, oh, it doesn't matter, and then it just decays your own feeling of confidence, your own feeling of the fact that, you know, if you say you're going to do something, you will do it, almost eating away at your own integrity. So a really, really good month for me. I've actually really enjoyed it. It's been great to have a chance to relax and spend more time with the kids. I'm back at work. Things are looking great. I really feel that I'm on track to achieve all the things that I said I will. So stay with me. I've only got a few more months until the 2 years of this blogging is up. And I expect to give you some very, very exciting news. If not by the next blog, certainly by the one after that. Be well. Thank you.